Here we are on Tel Megiddo, which is located in the northern region of Israel. And it is strategically located here specifically, I think, for its military positioning in the future. When you think of this specific region, you'll think of an hourglass where off to the west of Megiddo, you have the Mediterranean Sea. And then on the east, you're bordered by the Jordan River. And somewhere in between there, in the middle, is Tel Megiddo. And that's where we are at now in this location. And it's a beautiful scenic overlook. And there's a lot of historical things really important here with this site. So one of the most significant finds on this specific site is an altar that dates back to the time that the Canaanites ruled in this area. And what's really interesting about this altar is this is what's known as a high place in the Old Testament, where they offered sacrifices, animal sacrifices to their gods. And about 80% of the remains that are found are all animal sacrifices. They're all animal remains. But I've heard some rumor that in this specific spot is where there were remains of human sacrifices found. And what I think of when I think of this specific site is I think of man's attempt to merit favor from God. And it's a really sad testament to this fact. We find all over in the New Testament and the Old Testament men and women trying to earn favor with God. They're trying to earn, in a sense, their salvation, how God looks at them. And when I come to this site in Megiddo here in Israel, I always think about how we as Christians are not trying to earn our favor with God by some sort of sacrifice we do. It's only by the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. And folks, I just want to share with you a quick gospel presentation that this site reminds me so very much of, and that is this. I want this hand right here to represent you and me, and I want this wallet to represent all of our sin. In this time period, back in when the Canaanites were here, they would offer all sorts of sacrifices, kind of maybe what you would find as and you come into a church and you find people who are offering sacrifices of baptism to God, and they get baptized, and some people are offering sacrifices of money. Some people are offering sacrifices of church membership or time or just even coming to church. There are people that offer sacrifices of even turning from sin and promising. They're saying, Lord, I promise I'm going to turn over a new leaf and I'm not going to sin anymore. And I promise you that I'm going to be a better person. And while all this is really good, none of this is good enough to earn your favor with God. There's only one way to earn favor with God, and that's by Jesus Christ, who came to die on the cross for your sin. I want to show you this real quickly. I want this hand right here to represent the Lord Jesus, who 2,000 years ago came to this earth to die on the cross for our sin. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is not offering animal sacrifices to God. The wages of sin is not offering your money to God. It's not offering grain, and it's not offering baptisms. It's not works of righteousness which you can do. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. 2,000 years ago, Jesus came on this earth to die on the cross for your sin. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. He came to this earth to die on the cross for our sin. And that, my friend, earns favor in the sight of God. It's not by the works of righteousness which we have done. It's not the things we do. It's not our sacrifices to God, like maybe the Canaanites were trying to do and other civilizations during periods of time. It's when we, in the quietness of our own mind, trust Jesus Christ as our personal Savior. It's not making Him Lord or Lord of our life. It's trusting Him as our Savior. And friends, if you do that today, right here, in the quietness of your mind, you will have eternal life with Christ. And nothing can ever separate you from that wonderful salvation that you have. So friends, I ask that you do that. I ask that you trust Him as your Savior. Don't offer your works. Don't offer your baptism. Don't offer your turning from sin. You don't have to offer Him your life. All you need to do is believe in Christ alone as your personal Savior. So I beg of you that you would do that today.